Hello video creators, welcome to Suritium. In today's Premiere Pro tutorial, we're going to look at selective color grading. In Premiere Pro 13.0 and newer, there's a feature in the Lumetri color panel that Adobe calls selective color grading. This feature makes it easy to emphasize or subdue specific color ranges. And you could also use this to change the hue for a particular color range. Or you can increase or decrease the brightness of a selected color. You can desaturate shadows and saturate highlights if you want, and much more. Maybe this all sounds a bit complicated, but don't worry, I won't turn this one into a scientific, complex video. I will only show you the basics so you know how to use them. Just stay tuned and you'll see what I mean. Before we move over to Premiere, I want to tell you about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. It doesn't matter if you create videos for a living or just for a hobby, you need to know about Envato Elements. And that's because they offer millions of high-quality assets for your video projects, all within one single subscription. And this includes stock video, music and sound effects, fonts, video animation templates, and much more. I've got my own paid subscription for a couple of years now, and I still visit the website multiple times a week for many of my projects. So I can highly recommend you to give it a try if you like to create videos. If you use my temporary discount link in the video description, you can try them out for a couple of dollars. But of course, after you finished watching this tutorial. In Premiere, I've already got a clip on the timeline that we're going to use for the demo. I've got the clip selected, so now I can move over to the Lumetri color panel. In my layout, you can find this here. If you can't find this panel, you might need to enable it first, here in the Window menu. In the Lumetri color panel, you will find the new controls in the Curves section. These selective color grading tools are a new approach to the well-known Curves tools. And this will give you a lot more control over your color grading compared to previous versions. If you have worked in older versions of Premiere, you might be familiar with this color wheel. This has been replaced with 5 new Curves scopes. The first one is Hue versus Saturation. Next we've got Hue versus Hue. Then we've got Hue versus Luma. Luma versus Saturation. And Saturation versus Saturation. In my editing work, these top two controls are definitely my favorite, but we're going to look at each one of them in this tutorial. We're going to start with Hue versus Saturation, and we're going to use the clip on the timeline as an example. Let's assume that we want to increase the saturation for the orange color, but we don't want to change anything else in the shot. We can use the eyedropper tool, which you can enable here, to select the orange hue range. After that, three dots will appear here on the horizontal hue line. You can now take this midpoint and then move this up to increase saturation, or move it down to decrease saturation. And as you can see, we're now only mainly impacting the orange color and nothing else in the shot. And you can see this even better when I enable or disable the effect. You can also create the opposite by moving the outer dots up or down. If you move them down, you can desaturate everything except the orange hue range. And if needed, you can also extend this range by moving the dots to the left or the right. Of course, this is an extreme example, but this way you can really see the power of this control. Another example is this shot with flowers on a bright blue background. And let's say that we want to decrease the saturation for this blue bright color in the background. We can use the eyedropper tool to select the blue hue range and then lower the saturation by moving the midpoint down. But as you can see, it still has a bit of a blue glow, especially here on the edges of the leaves. In this case, we can fix this by adding more points to the hue line by left-clicking on it and then expand the hue range. And now with this extended range, everything blue in the frame has been desaturated. Next, we're going to look at Hue versus Hue, another powerful tool that I use a lot. In the first example, I'm going to change the yellow background. And to do this, I'm going to enable the eyedropper tool and then select the yellow background color. Hue versus Hue allows you to change the selected range into another hue or color. If I select the middle dot, you can see the colored line on the vertical axis. So this means when you move it up or down, you can change the selection into another hue. Of course, it does have its limitations, but still you can push this quite far as you can see here. I've also used this Hue versus Hue control on the background video for this Envato ad that you saw earlier in this video. And in case you're wondering, this is the original color for this background video that I used. For the next example clip, I'm going to apply a color grading LUT, simply set a color preset. And you can do this in the creative section of the Lumetri color panel. You can use these arrow buttons here on the side to preview the LUTs. And in this case, I'll go for the SL Big LUT. I think that the background looks great, but now there's a problem with her skin tones. Of course, it's not a complete disaster, but you can clearly see that it's somewhat yellow now. And that's a perfect case for the U versus U curves control. I can use the eyedropper tool to make a selection and then slightly move it up to create a more natural skin tone. I think this already looks a lot better, and of course, I'm only adjusting based on what I'm seeing. If you want to be 100% sure you have the right skin tones, you should also use the skin tone line in the Lumetri scopes panel, for example. But that's a topic for another video. Before we move over to the next control, let's see the difference when I turn this on and off. Next, we're going to look at U versus Luma. This, simply said, adds more or less brightness to a specific color. So in this example clip, I want to increase the Luma or brightness for the yellow flowers and make them stand out a little more. I'm going to make the selection with the eyedropper tool, and if I select the middle dot, you can see the brightness on the vertical axis. As you can see, up will make it brighter and down will make it darker. A slight increase of Luma for the yellow flowers can make a big difference. We can do the same, but the opposite, to the sky and add some more contrast with the clouds. And again, I can use the eyedropper tool to select the blue hue and then lower the Luma to make it a little darker. You can see the difference when I toggle this effect on and off. And just for comparison, it is different compared to the contrast and saturation sliders in the basics correction section. These two sliders will impact everything, but the U versus Luma curves controls will target specific U ranges. So again, a very powerful tool if you know how to use them. For Luma versus Set, we're going to use this same clip again. If I disable the LUT that we just applied earlier in this video, you can see that her clothes are almost black. With the LUT enabled, this is bluer. Something like this could be corrected with Luma versus Set curves controls, because this one adds saturation based on Luma, or brightness of your image. On the right, it starts with the whites and the highlights. In the middle, you'll find the midtones, and on the left, the shadows and the blacks. Her clothes are very dark, so we can add some points to the line at the point of the shadows and the blacks, and then move the points down to lower the saturation. And as you can see, that fixed the blue color problem without affecting the rest of the picture. Another example would be this shot, where I would like to make the snow less saturated or more white. And again, we can add some points to the saturation line and then move them down to decrease the saturation. And finally, we've got Set versus Set. This saturation curves tool gives you more control compared to the global saturation slider in the basics correction section. That slider is all or nothing, but with Set versus Set, you can balance the saturation. On the left, you've got the lesser saturated areas, and on the right, the parts with most saturation. Knowing this can help you to balance saturation in your image. I know it's hard to visualize until you see it. So I'm going to add some points to the line and then make a curve like this. Now only the most saturated part of the image, the yellow background, is still colored. But the subject in the middle that had less saturation is now completely colorless. But if I change the curve to the opposite, you can see that the subject in the middle gets the most saturation and the yellow background is almost colorless. And of course, this is an extreme example, but knowing this can help you to balance the saturation in your image. So if I would like, I can make a curve like this and make the subject in the middle more saturated. Time for a final before and after, and then we're going to conclude this tutorial. Like I said, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, then if you did, you might also want to check out one of these two videos. Anyway, as always, I would like to say thanks for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.